This morning we are swearing in the only other appointee in government, the non-elected political appointee in government, and it is significant. I believe this is the first time in the life of this republic this is happening, and it is deliberately so. Outside of myself and the deputy governor who contested elections, he's Mr. Osarodion Ogye, is the only political appointee in our government as for now.
Hello, delightful viewers. Welcome to another mind-blowing episode on Ebo TV. And I am your host for today, Constance Obasogie. Guess what? Today's activity just got bigger with enough spice. I mean, today's episode will be mind-blowing because I'm going to be giving you updates on the inauguration of Osarodion Ogye Esquire as the secretary to the state government. The Edo State Governor, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, on Wednesday swore in the secretary to the state government, Osarodion Ogye Esquire, and urged him to remain undaunted and focused in the discharge of his duties. The swearing-in ceremony held at Government House, Benin City, Edo State Capital. The governor reiterated that the process of the job will continue in our quest to restructure our systems for efficient service delivery to Edo people, noting, "We started this journey together. Ogye is part of the whole process. The advice I have is for you to brace up to face more pressure than ever before. This is because one of the most difficult things in life is to change an age system or to try to get an old person to change their ways. What we are attempting to do in the next 4 years will not be easy, and we need all the support we can to make Edo great again." Dignitaries at the event include Edo People's Democratic Party PDP Chairman Mr. Tony Aziegbemi, National Vice Chairman PDP South South Mr. Dan Obi, and Chairman Edo State Chapter of the All Progressive Congress APC Mr. Anselm Ojezwa. Others are former senators, Edo State Senatorial District Senior Senator Odion Ogbesia, former Senator Edo State Senatorial District Senator Roland Owere, Edo State PDP leader Honorable Chasi Dahosa, former Special Advisor on Political Matters Osaro Ida, amongst others. Yes, and from us at Nebo TV, we would like to say congratulations to Mr. Osarodion Ogye Esquire. Yes, the governor of Edo State, as from what we can see, started work in office. But mind you, the question still hanging in the minds of the people of Edo State is the fact that they do not know if the governor will retain the former members of his cabinet or not. Let's know your views on this by dropping a comment in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to Nebo TV and click on the subscription button and the notification bell so as to get more updates on our episode from Nebo TV.
Congratulations. You know how the new re-energized SSD,
Head of Service, Barrister Okungbowa. Let me acknowledge and welcome our party leaders who have come to witness this very significant event this morning, and to thank you for the understanding and the support which you have continued to show to our administration. This morning we are swearing in the only other appointee in government, the non-elected political appointee in government, and it is significant. I believe this is the first time in the life of this republic this is happening, and it is deliberately so. Outside of myself and the deputy governor who contested elections, he's Mr. Osarodion Ogye, is the only political appointee in our government as for now. And the reason why we decided on this step of action is because we realized that having gone through the political turmoil and the electioneering which we went through, God Almighty was clearly sending us on an errand. and going around the state with our political leaders during the electioneering, we all heard the voices of our people, what they believed they wanted us to do for them when we are in office. And clearly we came to the realization that it will be impossible to deliver the services our people require if we do not re-engineer government. And that is why we did ask, and we're very, you know, glad and grateful that our political leaders understood when we said that we should be given a 3-month period to review government, to look at the entrails, the workings of government, and to try as much as we can to realign the purpose of government, which is to deliver public services with the dictates of democracy. And we are glad that we are doing so, because with the activities that we have undertaken with the permanent secretaries and the civil servants over the last few weeks, it has become very, very clear that restructuring of this country has to start at home, has to start with the structures of government. And hopefully we will then move on to real devolution of power. We are swearing in Mr. Osaudiongye, Barrister Osaudiongye, this morning. We started this journey together, and so I'm not going to sit here this morning to give you a charge. You know the charge. You are part of this whole process. The only advice is that you are going to face pressure like you have never faced before. Because one of the most difficult things in life is to change an aged system, or to try and get an old person to change their ways. So what we're attempting to do the next 4 years, we know will not be easy. Trying to get an aged system to now begin to work and be efficient and respond to the needs of our people. There will be extreme pressure on you, since you are that interface with the political system, because people will want to do the things the way they are used to doing, and they may not be able to understand as much as you do or I do the imperatives for change. We were all witnesses to what happened in this country and in this state a couple of weeks ago under the NSAS demonstrations, which was taken over by hoodlums. You saw what happened in some parts of the country. And we all realize that that is a wake-up call, that if we do not begin that rapid restructuring, that rapid transformation to give the next generation an opportunity and hope, then we may all be victims. So as you go about your duties this term, please understand that it is God, only God, that made it possible for us to be here today and for us to have won our elections. And it is God Almighty we owe all allegiances. Whatever you know it is not right, is not pleasing to God and his people, please do not do. Because you are the one that will have to answer to him. I shouldn't be telling you this, I know you know already, but be rest assured that the way we started is the way we'll end by the grace of God. Our purpose is service. Our purpose is to serve our people. Whatever God has for you as an opportunity, he only knows. So do not think that by pleasing one person today and doing something that will favor a group to the disadvantage of another will be placing you in an advantage position for the future. Only God knows the future. So I want to use this opportunity to congratulate you and to thank you for your steadfastness, your loyalty, and your implicit faith in God, and to assure you that as long as God continues to give us life, you know, you have nothing to fear in terms of our friendship, loyalty, and brotherhood. Congratulations.
Well, like Mr. Governor said, we give all the glory to God, because it's only God who made it possible for us to be here today. Like you also said, I have been a part of it. I have been an insider, so I'm not a stranger to the vision and the path you have charted for Edo State. I want to reiterate, because like you also said, I don't need to say it, but maybe for emphasis, your dream for Edo State, I know, is to move Edo forward. And I'll be one of the pillars, and I want to give my word again that I will remain a pillar in that struggle, in that journey to make Edo State better. Let me thank our party leaders. Like you also said, we were in an unusual time. We fought an unusual election. But they've shown understanding. And I want to join Mr. Governor to thank and to appeal to you to continue to show that understanding, because at the end of the day, all our interests is the same. For my colleagues in government, I will not change. Like Mr. Gordon said, I have not changed. But I want to appeal to the HOS and our colleagues, the civil servants. Like I mentioned when I met with them, it's going to be tough. It's going to be tough. But at the end of the day, it will all come out better for our people, for Edo State. Mr. Gordon, you can sleep. You can go to sleep and know that somebody is standing by you. I want to thank you for the belief, for the trust you have in me. If I talk about Mr. Governor, I'm also talking about, of course, my brother, the Deputy Governor. We give God the glory, because nobody thought we'll be here today. It has been struggle. But God has shown that He is God, and He will never change. He remains our God, and we will not change. Thank you very much.